What's up guys, this is Balázs from Racing Brick. After publishing my video about the Powered Up 3.3 update yesterday, I received some enlightening comments from you, and I had to realize that I was so focused on the calibration itself that I totally missed the obvious purpose of the two new blocks. I guess this happens when we only get a single sentence as information about the new blocks, and we need to figure out everything by ourselves. This time I was losing in the guessing game. So, about those blocks. The first one is not for calibration only, although the calibration really runs every time you start the program. With the value field, it is actually possible to connect the slider input to it, and we already have a simple but effective steering solution. It works surprisingly well with the L motor, there's no trembling or significant overshoot effect, so there are more things going on in it than I expected. Actually, it would be really cool if it was a composite block and we could open it up to see how it works, but maybe that will also come one day. So that's the steering part, and the other block is not related to the steering, but it's for a simplified speed control. It can be used with the other slider, and with these two simple blocks we already have a fully working car control that works pretty well with the two sliders. It also works with the joystick interface, but I still prefer the slider one, as the joystick is too small for precise control. I think these two blocks are a step forward towards a simplified interface, which is a great thing. I hope to see more blocks like that. My only concern is the fact that they don't have any additional parameters, and it is not possible to see what's going on inside. As I said, I would love to see these as composite blocks, with a simple mode for beginners, but also providing an advanced view for the folks who'd like to understand what's going on inside and would like to change a few things. It would also have a great educational value. According to the description, this block is advised to be used only with the rally car and the 4x4 extreme off-roader. I guess this was added because it works only if the L motor is used as a servo, so you can actually use it for any custom creation that is steered with the L motor. In theory, the XL motor should have the same capabilities, but as you see here, it has some challenges finding the proper position due to the speed of rotation and the overshoot effect. Let's see a quick step-by-step setup with the slider interface and the rally car. As you see, all we have to do is to remove these two default blocks, add the two new ones, and assign the slider input blocks to them. That's all. When we start the profile, the calibration runs automatically, and the car can be controlled. I found the calibration to be a little inaccurate sometimes. There are cases when the car won't go that straight. Of course, it is possible to add some fine tuning to the code, just like I did with the previous custom control layout. Here's a simplified and updated version of the code for the two slider interface. It uses the new blocks. The first button can be used to toggle a light on the car, and the two others can be used to fine tune the center position. There's a link in the top right corner to the download page, and you can also find it in the description. Here is how it works. The calibration runs when the car is turned on. If it does not run fully straight, then you can adjust the zero position with these two buttons. They are adjusting the relative zero by 3 degrees at a time. That value can be changed if needed. And the first button toggles the lights. So, now that we clarified the purpose of the two new blocks, I'm looking forward to see what we receive next, but I really hope we'll get more guidelines with the next release. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up, you can also subscribe, and tap the notification bell if you don't want to miss my technic reviews and other LEGO RC videos. See you next time, bye bye!